Dueler. We'll be right back. and gonna do some Yu-Gi-Oh today, and we're gonna be live with my wife Ryoko Umbra. She's joining us. She's also streaming on her Twitch channel. So we're gonna be playing some Yu-Gi-Oh here in a second. I think she's getting her stream sorted out right now. Hang on just a second. Alright, let me pull this up here. I've got a custom room set up, and she'll join here in a minute. I will pull up, I'll unmute myself on Discord over here in a second. We're having some Heineken beer tonight and chilling, and we're going to do some Yu-Gi-Oh! Dueling Nexus. If you ever want to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Dueling Nexus, and you can build all your own decks, you can do pretty much, you can make custom rooms where invalid decks are allowed, invalid decks are not allowed, and stuff like that. But it's a lot of fun. If you like Yu-Gi-Oh!, I'd recommend checking out this site. There's always people online, so it's definitely worth looking into. I've been playing on this site since, I want to say maybe 2017, and it's gotten better and better over the years, so I definitely recommend this one. Let me pull up Discord here. Testing Discord. She might be having some issues on her end, but that's all right. We will give her just a second.
Are you okay?
Yeah. How's your stream? I've got my stream up on this end. Let me send you the link to this dueling room. We'll give her just a second. I think she's getting her stream sorted out. I'll look at Dueling Nexus with you real quick. If you haven't seen it before, I'll show you the deck that I'm using tonight. This is mainly a spell trap deck. It's built around the idea of getting equip cards brought to the field, like these, or these are ideal. And you start equipping things like, where are they at? Where's my equips? Here we go. Some of these or some of these. And you can easily get these cards over 100,000. So it's a very good way to, now, if you're playing against the wrong deck, it can shut this deck out, but It's a pretty decent deck for what it does if you're playing against a deck that doesn't necessarily have easy ways of shutting all these out. You'll notice there's no actual monster cards here. They're all trap monster cards. Or, trap...
Can you still hear me?
Hang on. Yeah. Are you loaded into the room?
I guess it helps whenever I actually select things.
Good to go. she got me on that. Alright, let's see how this goes. Okay, that'll let me add one equip spell. We will set that here. We'll set a mirror force here. We're gonna keep this one in our hand.
Is it loading on your side?
Slowly, I've been able to put a couple cards down. Here we go. We will play this. So, Black Garden is a card that allows me to, basically anytime, monsters are brought out to the field on either side, a rose token goes to the other side of the field, and those also act as good things that I can equip, these equip cards to. She got here. Target one. Oh, okay, she's gonna get rid of it. Well played, I guess. Not a problem, though.
I know.
Your turn. Let's see how this shakes out. Now the good part about this is I can easily, you can lay cards down really easily with this deck. I might put this as a deck build on GitHub. This has been a pretty good deck. Over the last few years, I've done pretty decent with this deck. Got your swords there. Pull that real quick. I'm gonna grab my OBS window and move it to my other monitor so I can see it better. There we go. Now I can keep an eye on chat a little better. Just in case anyone pops in. Feels like chatting today. During our cozy dueling session. So, this. Oh, hang on. I'm actually gonna move my chat window right over here as well so I can see it better. So she's rocking her Trickstar deck tonight. running trick stars, are we? Damn Lily Bill. Get this. Here we go. Get rid of these before they can. The key with this deck, too, is also getting a halfway decent hand. Well, I guess she had a way to. Okay, yeah, I didn't read that effect close enough. And that's another key to reading the effect close enough. Always read that effect close enough, I guess. That's what I didn't do. We'll have another beer here in a second and keep on trucking along with our duel. We'll probably have several duels. I guess we'll have a best 3 out of 5 or something like that and see how it goes. Oh yeah, I need to pull my chat back up. Yep, there's that rose token. That's what I was hoping for. Ah, shit. The field card. That's what I didn't read close enough. She can target set cards. Yep. Okay, I need to get rid of that. And again, if you're just joining us, this is duelingnexus.com. Very good site for the shit. Very good site for this kind of stuff. I need to pull a good card or... Yep, never mind. I did not pull a good hand.
Did you not?
Apparently not.
I feel like I pulled a fairly decent one for once.
So this card on the field... Oh, shit, hang on. It's the only thing I don't like about this game. This card on the field allows her to select this monster in her hand. Target one Trickstar monster she controls, except Trickstar like Horus. Special summon this card, and if she does, return that monster to the hand. Each time a card is added to your opponent's hand, inflict 200 damage to them for each. So I need to get away. Yep. There's the effects of that coming through. There's also Lilybell, which can attack directly at any time, regardless of whether or not I have monsters on the field. And she has the ability with the field card to negate traps, which I set, so because I was hoping I had something better to come along, but I did not. Hopefully the next game I get a better hand or upper I switch decks, but we'll see what happens. Instagram window the way here. I put it up earlier to put the stream up for anyone that wanted to see it. I'll save that. I'll eat a little bit of damage. Okay. I guess I should have used it. Oh well. Yeah, that's the effects of a bad hand. Let's see. We will set this. And then we'll equip this to this. It doesn't help because the swords are still on the field, but we can at least have something. Shit. I should have turned those to defense. I did not think about that. On Discord. Can we lose you for a sec there? Testing. She's back in the room, but she might have her She might be having problems with her voice thing. Get rid of this useless window here. There we go. Alright. I've got 4 tokens on the field now. Of course, 4 of them can be attacked fairly easily. Yeah, she's gonna destroy a couple real quick. We'll pop another beer while the battle phase goes on. Well, I might can defend myself once. I don't know what she attacked with, but I'm just gonna do it. Some of my favorite tonight, Heineken. We will let that one slide so I can keep the attack up here. I'll sacrifice some LPs for that. In a second, we'll set these in defense, and hopefully we'll pull an equip. Well, this kind of works too. I don't know if I'm hitting some lag or... Here we go. Then we will get rid of this. This thing's a pain. Damn it. I still forgot to set that other one to defense. Oh well. I guess it's too late now. I'm probably gonna lose this duel anyway. I'm already to only 1900 LPs. That's gonna be my cylinder gone. I guess I should've used that. I keep forgetting she has her, what's this card called? Light stage? Yeah, Trickstar light stage on the field. See what's about to happen here. That's gonna pull another rose token. Which gives me a little bit of help for protecting against some higher see what that pulls. This one allows, if she controls no monsters or all monsters she controls are trick stars, she can special summon this card from her hand during the damage step when her opponent's trick star monster battles an opponent monster. You can send this card from your hand to the graveyard. That monster you control gains attack equal to its original attack. Oh, shit. Until the end of this turn, and she can only use one Trickstar Corbane effect per turn, and only once that turn. This might wipe me out. Was this negated? I'm dead. Yep. GG. I'll open another room. Hello? Okay, do I want to stick with this deck? Or... that was kind of a shit hand. Test? Trying to see if her shit's working or not. So the cards in this deck, we've got Hippo Carnivals. They allow us to just bring three of these Hippo tokens up to the field, which can also be used for equipping these other cards too. If you can get a whole bunch of spells and traps on the field, and then you use something like this on one of these equipped cards or a token, it's a really good way to get that attack and defense, or that attack and defense up really quick. And having this on the field, where is it? The Black Garden? Having this on the field, bringing those rose tokens out, like, a second ago was a good example of a bad hand. Like, this deck is entirely dependent. Ideally, you want this, one of these, and some kind of something like this to help keep attacks at bay. Pot of Duality never hurts, or some Scapegoat to help give you a wall of defense while you get stuff set up. And we also have Swords of Revealing Light, you know, obviously, to keep attacks from happening while you get set up. But getting those equipped monsters on the field, that's what it's all about, so that you can easily sort of get that attack and defense up and start taking out what's on the field and doing damage to the life points on your opponent. Let me pop back over to Discord real quick and see if she's having issues. Test? Can you hear me there? I think she might be having issues. So we are going to keep this room open, but we're going to go over to a, another room and do a duel while she gets her stuff sorted out. This is, if you've never done Dueling Nexus, this is sort of the layout of the site. This is sort of the updates that they show you. And so let me check my... Okay, I had to pull OBS back up. When you're ready to duel, you can customize your decks right here, add new decks, like, so you can create deck, upload, browse public. Here's all mine. You can go to duel, and if we just want to get matched up with someone, we're going to hit single duel. We're going to accept. We are ready. And we'll go with scissors. I'll go second. I think I've seen this deck before. Mechankos. What is this? If this card is not equipped with an equipped card, it can take no damage from battles involving this card. If this card is equipped with an equipped card, it cannot be destroyed by battle. Opponent takes any battle damage. Okay. We'll set this. It says it can't destroy by battle. It doesn't say it can't be destroyed by other means. We will bring some of these out. Set this. That's a cylinder, so I'll keep this one in my hand, and we will destroy this. Oh, okay, I failed there. I didn't read enough. That's fine. Oh, maybe it is equipped. Okay, I did not see that. You can add one level 7 or lower ritual monster from deck to hand, then add one ritual monster from graveyard to hand. I should have double checked to make sure that was... Okay, what do I want to do here? These can't be destroyed right now by this. Which includes card effects. That doesn't mean I can't negate attacks. Even though I doubt there's going to be any. I really should just activate that. And the cool part about this is when you equip stuff, these cards that are technically monsters but are also trap cards, technically also count as trap cards still. So they gain that effect of being able to, with mage power, still count towards the 500 plus attack and defense. Okay, so it doesn't look like they can be damaged by battle, but we can still increase I don't want to waste a spot for that one. I don't think I've seen these Minkenko cards before. Okay, now it's time to have some fun. I know he's gonna take damage. Oh shit. What? What did I miss there? I'm not reading these effects close enough to not. Oh, okay. All right. This is an interesting deck. I need to read their effects closer every time he brings one out. I can't destroy them with these, and attacking them with my own monsters affects me, so I need to be careful there. Yep, that was it for me. So I think she has her stuff. I've got her on Telegram over here. She's saying this room isn't working, so we'll make a new room. Excuse me. Host dual, private, allowed, and create. Testing. Testing. Do I want to use this deck again, or... This is her first stream, so I think she's trying to get her stuff figured out. She's having problems with her microphone. There's a open source Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro, what was it called? Open source client. I want to check this one out sometime. Test. I think she's having problems with her audio. There's a open source, is it called Eden something, I think? Edo Pro, here we go, hang on. Okay, it was on the Project Ignis website. On Windows, Mac, and Linux. I don't have it right now, but I'm going to download it soon, and we might play with it on the next stream. I've seen YouTube videos of people playing with it, and it looks pretty neat. So, I was thinking that might be a fun idea for a stream. Still giving her a second to get her thing figured out. I might take a short break here in just a second and go over there, and she's in the other house, so I might go give her a hand and see if she's having problems with something. Okay, yeah, I think she's having an issue, so we will get some songs playing for you real quick, and give me just a minute. Okay, so I'll give you a song that you can listen to real quick, and I'm gonna go give her a hand with her stream, so. And then we will be right back. What would be a good song? These are all original songs, so. I hold the copyright, so it's okay. Here you go. This is a good one. Alright, we're back. I think we got our stuff sorted. Let me pull Discord back up. Testing. Are you muted? Be going a little slow. Her Discord's having issues, so I'm gonna call her on Telegram and see if that helps. Test.
Yes.
Is that better?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's better. I'm gonna get rid of my...
I'm wondering if...
Hang on, I wanna get rid of my disc. I'm getting rid of my Discord real quick.
Okay. I think Brave might be causing... issues today.
Can I get OBS full screen? There we go. There we go. Okay. Now I can finally start.
Okay. Maybe this will work a little bit better. I can't believe that none of the audio is working for the first half of that.
It happens sometimes. It's only your first stream.
Well...
Is this not loading for you?
Okay. It's not loading for me. Oh, wait, hold on. It's trying.
There we go.
There we go.
I don't think you had readied up all the way.
I might not have.
Okay. So we are going to play...
Is it just me, or does it seem like they changed their music?
They might have. I'm not playing their music. I've got mine muted.
Not sure where to go to mute that, actually.
Go to options, and there's like a slider wheel, and you can turn it down. I guess we'll just do this over Telegram from now on. Discord was kind of iffy earlier.
Yeah. I mean, it works fine until I start doing other things. It was working fine earlier. It's just this part.
Got rid of that extra Firefox window since we didn't need that anymore. Seems like Telegram's gonna be the best option for doing this. The fun part about this stream is all of this is happening over crappy satellite internet. We currently have HughesNet. Don't get it. It was our only option. But we have Starlink coming, so that's gonna be nice. I'm excited to be streaming over Starlink soon. I don't know if she's going to be running her Trickstar deck or something else. So, just a quick aside, if you are just joining the stream and you're wondering what we're playing, check out this sometime. It's Yu-Gi-Oh! Dueling Nexus. It's a lot of fun. It's a good way to test different decks and play against different people. People are always online. You can play against friends by building your own room, or by hosting your own room. You can build your own decks. There are different, oh, hang on just a second, it's my turn. So she's got one set in defense mode and one magic or trap set. Okay, we will set this here. And we will to summon that next turn. Okay. Playing at KG. See where this
did you
goes.
Say
yeah, sorry, I'm old.
To be fair, I think I'm gonna be you from the first round that we played. So I have not got a great hand.
To be fair, I don't have a great hand right now. think Telegram audio might be the way to go from now on this.
It's a lot clearer, and there's not nearly as much lag.
Yeah, I was noticing that too. At least until we get Starlink.
Hopefully soon. Hopefully soon.
Next week, if all things go according to plan.
Yeah. Oh, I guess I'm supposed to do something here.
Yep, it's waiting on you.
I have no idea what it's waiting on me for now.
Pry your face down.
I guess it's making me useful.
Not a problem. I can reactivate this in a second.
Too afraid to not realize it was my turn.
If your cards are flashing, that's a good indication. Okay, I'll activate this first.
That apparently
some did cards
not
on the field.
For my brain to understand that.
Okay, we'll equip this in a second. We'll put this here. This here. And this here.
Oh, is this your weird hippo deck?
I guess you're about to find out. Attack right this second because I don't know what that face down is, so I'm going to see if I can get rid of that in the next turn. Oh, never mind. That's going to take care of that. That's okay. That'll give me a second to build stuff up. So this is the ideal sort of what you want with this deck. I've already got Stingray here. Sort of brought up to where he needs to be. Like, it would already take... I mean, depending on what she has, I don't know what deck she's running yet, but it is easily... It could be easily poppable, but it might not be easily poppable with an attack of 4,400. I believe she runs swords on every deck she has. I'm not sure. But we will find out what she's running here in a second. I see she has an MST... And she got rid of... What was this? This Black Garden a minute ago. So... we can't do anything just yet for two more turns because of the swords. But we can do this. Just to give him some more attack. And then we can do that. Building her on up. So that gives me a minute to... Oh, never mind. I guess it's my turn again. We'll grab another beer here in a second. We will set this. And we will wait until that swords runs out of steam. Happy Saturday morning to everyone. Friday night, whatever you want to consider it. I guess depending on what time zone you're in. For me, it's almost 1 a.m. We're going to have another adult beverage and continue our Yu-Gi-Oh game here. Cheers to all y'all and happy weekend. So that might be the end phase for... Oh, the swords might have one more turn. Okay. So I can't do nothing with... I could summon this. Put a rose token on her side of the field. Have yourself a rose. This card is sent to the graveyard as link material. For this link summon of a Trickstar monster, you can special summon this card, but banish it when it leaves the field. You can only use this effect of Trickstar Nightshade once per turn. You will notice my Stingray, as long as it stays safe, is currently 9,900 attack and 8,000 defense. So that's a pretty decent... This suck.
I think this is probably the worst hand that I've had.
I've got my Stingray pretty happy. He's nice and hungry and ready for dinner. Each time a Trickstar monster is normal or special summoned to a zone, this card points to. Should inflict 200 damage to me. Trickstar monsters this card points to cannot be destroyed by battle or card effects. If your opponent takes damage by a Trickstar monster's effect. Hang on. If your opponent takes damage by a Trickstar monster's effect, this card gains attack equal to the damage they took until the end of this turn. I keep that one in mind for a Holy Angel there. I do have a Trickstar deck, but I rarely use it. And, of course, she can't summon Rose tokens to my side of the field because my side of the field is currently full. We need to get rid of... Does it say these can't be destroyed by battle? Okay. By battle or card effects. We're going to figure that out. We can get rid of this. So, for the moment... I say we do this. I want to see what this face down is. It might fuck me. It might. I don't. Let's find out. What we got? A dream sprite. Okay. Fair enough. So then we'll take this thing out. Or we're about to get fucked. Maybe this is a mirror force. Watch this be a mirror force. Oh! I honestly thought you had a mirror force on the field. What was your face down? I'm sending you a link to the next one. So, do I want to switch my deck or do I want to stick with the same one? Test. I don't remember what this Trap Tricks deck was. I know what it is, but I can't remember what all I had in it. Test. Can you hear me? So many things are going to be better when we get Starlink.
Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, can you hear me? Testy test. We can at least still duel even if the voice is messed up. fun part of this stream is it's happening from way out in the woods. And we've
now,
had...
Can you hear me?
Hang on. Yeah, can you hear me?
I'm still not getting you.
Hello? Hello? I wonder if it's my microphone source. Hang on a second. Test?
Are you hearing me?
Yeah, can you hear me?
I'm still not getting any audio at all.
Test, test, test. Just sec. I think her internet hotspots having issues. I guess she can't hear me, but I can hear her. I don't know if it's on my end or her end. Fun IT issues right during the middle of the stream.
Seems like we're still...
Hi, Lori. How are you doing? We're currently troubleshooting issues on our guests in, so we're trying to get that figured out, but we're getting a duel ready. Thanks for dropping by. Give me just a second. We're working on some audio issues on our guest's end here. If you can hear me, you can ready up on the duel if you want to. We're just having a chill night and dueling. And, give me just a second. There we go. We're playing Dueling Nexus. If you haven't heard of it before, I think I have a window up. Right here. You should check it out. You can build decks. You can host duels. You can join duels. You can do matches with friends. That's what we're doing tonight. We've got my wife on the other end of the stream. She's streaming on her Twitch channel. And we are just kind of having a chill Friday night. And we are going to start the duel. I hadn't seen that she'd write it up because the sound didn't come through. We'll go with paper. Sweet. And we will go second. put my chat window into my OBS here. If I have any audio issues, my apologies. We've been kind of fighting with that tonight. The fun part about living out in the woods without... We're just about to get Starlink, and I'm excited for that, but... So, she's got her swords on the field already. We have our own swords. We've got one mirror force. We've got two mirror forces, an armory call. This will let us bring, once we get a trap monster, well, we can equip it to this one right here, actually. This will let us bring in something like mage power to bring our monster up like we did last game. So... She's laid something down in defense mode. We'll have a quick cigarette while we play here. Let me make me just a little smaller so you can see her side of the field better, I think. There we go. And again, just for reference, if you're just joining us, I don't have my stream. I've got my OBS on one monitor and the Duel in the other. So, if you have any questions about my deck, this is a quick view at it. So, if you're in here, I don't have my stream manager up right now. So, if you're in here and you have questions about the deck, feel free to drop it in the chat. We will put one mirror force down, one of these down, one of these down, one of these down, and the swords of our own. That should keep us safe for a sec while we build up our own defensive strategy. If you're still in the chat, Lori, what kind of deck do you run? So she's got a dream sprite on the field. When this is attacked by my monster, select one or more monster cards and designate it as an attack target, then calculate damage. So it basically acts as a redirect for attacks that I might throw at it. But if it's the only monster on the field, which with swords on the field, I doubt that's going to be the case, but... We'll find out. Mic test. Okay, cool. I'll turn it down just a little bit in my OBS because it looked like it was spiking a second ago. If you're wondering, I use a blue snowball. I've had this guy for about maybe 4 or 5 years. It's been a pretty good mic through the years. Been through a lot of streams and some recording sessions. I think I need to move my... There we go. Probably let her know she's only got 80. Oh, never mind. Now some cards are moving. What's this? This is a new deck. Armor Age Bergamot. When your life points is higher than your opponent's, if a plant type monster I control attacks a defense position monster, inflict piercing battle damage. Once per turn, if you gain LP, this card gains 1,000 attack and defense until the end of your opponent's turn. Okay. We will start with this. Put it in defense for the moment. We will use Armory Call. I don't think she currently has anything that can negate it. We'll bring out Mage Power. We'll equip it to this. And then I'm tempted to use this, but we will use this and make another. We'll use this next turn to equip. Now, if I could get some tokens, that would be ideal, because then I could equip United We Stand here, and that brings 800 attack and defense for each face-up monster I control. Put that in defense. And we'll get rid of that. And that's the point of this deck. You build that attack up as much as you can with the equip spells. Let's see what's gonna happen next. Got that LP back up pretty quick. Try this one more time, just for the fun of it. Test. I already have one of these down. One of each, so I'm not going to use them just yet. But we can get rid of this. Attack mode. I wonder what the plan is here. Okay. If this card is linked, summoned in the extra monster zone using Sunseed Genius Loki as material, you can add one Sunvine spell trap from your deck to your hand. This card cannot be targeted for attacks, but does not prevent your opponent from attacking you directly. Once per turn, if you take battle or effect damage, you can gain that much LP, and if you do, special summon one Sunvine monster from your extra deck. Okay. And this is just another 600 defense. Okay, we're going for the long play here. I still need to learn more about this deck. It was kind of an interesting deck that he was playing. A Sunseed Twin on the field now, and another Genius Loki. I wonder if that's going to bring another one of these to the field. She knows she only has 40 seconds left. Never mind. Another one of those came out, huh? Get rid of this real quick. Oh. Okay. Is that a once per turn situation? It's a once per turn situation. Okay. That's about all I can do for now. If this makes it till the next turn, I can position it. Need to find a way to get rid of this one. But that depends on what I draw. Throw some tunage on in the background, I think. Nothing new so far. All this is original tunes, and if you want it, you can download any of it from my SoundCloud. What do we want to go with? This going. Okay. We'll go with this one. Continue to get rid of them. Unless this is gonna fuck us. Something that can do piercing, but I don't think I've got that in this deck. See what happens here in a second. I don't know that much about the deck she's using. Sun Avalon. See what's rocking on the Sun Avalon stuff. No, hang on, my turn. She got rid of my mage power. We'll use Pot real quick. Pot of Duality. That's a tough one. We'll go with Black Garden. And then here in a second, we will set this armory call and set these back to defense for the moment. So aside from that face down on that side of the field, there's not a whole lot to worry about. There's a defense. I guess I technically could have attacked directly earlier, but I still don't know what that face down is, and that's troublesome. Now we get a hippo token. we can use this real quick. We will grab this. We will use this. Drop these all in defense, and that'll up our attack heavily. And that'll give her a few rose tokens, and that's okay. Then I want to use this last one, right? Yes. See if this works. Oh, yep, we at least triggered that. And that means Unless we're about to see. Oh. We'll make a new room.
Is this working now?
Test. If you can hear me, I'm gonna make a new room. Can you hear me now? Test, test. I'm gonna take that as a negative. I don't know if that's on my end or her end, but that's okay. We will go. Oh, do I want to stick with this one? I think we're going to switch it up a bit. Ah, damn it. No. Oh, never mind. So we are using our Cybris deck this time around, so we're kind of changing things up just a little bit. We've got Math Mech. He can target one face-up monster on the field, cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of this turn, except for Cybris monsters, also special summon this card from your hand, but it cannot target this. It cannot attack this turn, and if you do, the targeted monster loses 1,000 attack until the end of this turn. You can only use this effect of Math Mech subtraction once per turn. We've got Synet Kodak. If a Code Talker monster is special summoned from the extra deck to your field, except during the damage step, you can target one of those monsters, add one Cybris monster from the same attribute from deck to hand. Also cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of this turn, except for Cybris monsters, except for even if this card leaves the field. You cannot add other monsters with that same attribute from your hand for the effect of Synet Kodak, assuming from the end of this turn. What we got over here, I think we're using Trick Stars, yep. Let me get another song going. And we will do some dueling. Thank you. best I got right now. Deck in a while, so this might go interesting. This one is all Cybers monsters I control gain 500 attack. If I control a Mathmech monster, I can send this face-up card from the field to the graveyard, then target one monster my opponent controls, destroy it. I can only use this effect of Mathmech Induction once per turn. And I do have two Mathmech monsters. I have one Mathmech and one Balancer Lord in my hand. That's a Lilybell and a Holy Angel. And just to get caught up on that, each time a Trickstar monster is normal or special summoned to a zone, this card points to inflict 200 damage to your opponent. Trickstar monsters, this card points to cannot be destroyed by battle or card effects. If your opponent takes damage by a Trickstar monster's effect, this card gains attack equal to that. Something that can take out those Tricksters pretty quick. We'll go with this one. Now just to be sure, I can target one face-up monster on the field. Cannot special summon monsters except Cybers monsters. Also special summon this card from my hand, and if I do, the target monster loses 8,000 attack. Okay, we'll go with this one. Not 8,000, 1,000. I was stupid. This. get rid of this. Oh. Oh, yeah, because, okay, never mind, that was done. Yeah, I can't attack anymore, so that's fine. Field. I re-encoded the video for your site because it sucks. Hi. Your website downloads like 150 megabytes of video to load, which is insane and is losing your customers because the page takes like 30 seconds to load and lags my MacBook. I re-encoded it to 5 megabytes VP9 because I got so annoyed. See a fellow Linux user using Windows. Got the battle phase going on here. I think she's gonna get me this time. I probably should use the other deck. I haven't used this deck in a while. I don't really remember what all was in it. Seems like a good time to get another beer, I guess. Sarcophagus. We'll use it. I put the ketchup to where it looked like his hair. And he started telling me that I couldn't eat it. And he had a wife and 7 kids at home to support. And I stood there with his hot dog and asked Terry, "Do you know this hot dog is talking to me?" And he says, "Nah, let's get out of here." He thought I was just faking. I don't know which one to go with, actually. I'll go with this one. It's a good card. And I guess we'll attack. I think we can. Nope. I haven't cracked the thing yet. I'm silly. might take a short break after this duel so I can hit the loo and see if my phone's charged yet and all that good stuff. Speaking of which, this is technically Cybers. Cybers monster I control will be used as link material for code talker. Okay, cool. Let's do it. Actually, let's reveal him. Gains 500 attack for each monster it points to. Okay, this is what we want. This might kill me, I hope not. Needs to point. It points this way. Oh, I only got 200 left. That was it. Okay. I told her that was a good one. Alright, I'm gonna take a short break. We will be back in about 15 minutes. I will leave you some music to listen to here. Put that one and this one and this one and this one. You probably won't need all of these, but just be sure. There we go. Alright, I'm going to take a short break. I'm gonna hit the loo, grab maybe a quick snack, and have a cigarette, and I will see you guys in about 15-20 minutes. Hey, we are back. Had a quick break there. Just a second. Getting some stuff wrapped up on our end. I'm gonna do probably one or two more card games, and then that'll probably be it for tonight, for tonight's stream. But we're about to get the next duel set up here in just a second, and I'm finishing a quick cigarette from our post break. But give me just a second, we will get that set up, and we will wrap tonight's stream up, and I'm planning on doing another one tomorrow. We're trying to get, this is her first stream, so we're trying to get that kind of solidified. She's on her internet, and I'm on our Wi-Fi, and here in a week or two, we're going to have Starlink, and that's going to be way better, so we'll be able to stream at the same time a lot better. But, yeah, anyway, give me just a second, and we're going to have another duel or two, and then we're going to probably going to call it a stream, and we'll probably do another one tomorrow, Sunday, whatever, and it'll be fun. Okay, let me make a new room real fast. Move my OBS window to my other monitor. Let me let her know my stream is back on. Okay. Let me make the room real fast. Dex, private game, create game. Once this loads in, I will switch decks and send her the link. And put me back in my normal space. I guess this might take just a second. Happy weekend to everyone. Wait a minute. make a new room. This one's taking a minute. Unless their servers are just being slow. Or maybe my internet's being slow. Let me check something. Let's see if she can host a game. Mine's being stupid for some reason. She's getting her room going. I think it's being slow on my end, so my internet's being stupid. Another reason I cannot wait to get Starlink. While we're waiting, I'll get another I'll get some more music going for us in the background. All of this is my original stuff, so it is completely okay for me to play anywhere. What have I not played yet? We'll go with this one. Okay, she just sent me a room. I don't know if my thing's being stupid. Can't join games. I guess my stuff is being slow. Oh, I'm getting red on my thing here too. Stupid. be about done for the night. I don't know if I can't... I don't know if I just can't join games, or if it's my, I don't know if it's the dueling nexus servers, or my internet just being stupid. Because I don't know if I can even... Let's see if I can join a single duel. Yeah, that might be about it. That might be a stream for tonight. Mine is being stupid. Give me just a second. Excuse me. I think I'm going to wind it down for tonight. We had a few good games, and I don't know if it's, I don't know if it's my internet being stupid, or if it's, on the Yu-Gi-Oh! Dueling Nexus side, but... I don't know, we might actually chill for just a minute more. Let me see if I can... Maybe we can have a quick cigarette together and watch something funny or something like that. What would be a fun wind down video or something? Oh, I know. If you haven't seen this guy before, look him up. His name on YouTube is, what is it? Super Stupid Poop. There was one that was really funny. I like to eat shit. Yeah, here it is. We'll watch this together. Have one more, have one more cigarette, and we'll call it a night. And we'll probably do a stream tomorrow and get some of her technical difficulties sorted out. And I don't know if that was, I don't know if that last bit of not being able to create a room was on my end or their end, but we'll get that figured out tomorrow. Just like she just sent me a message. Watch one or two of his videos together real quick because they're pretty great. The other one, hang on, there's two I want to show you of his. The other one is... what's it called? Whoops. Yeah, we'll just go with this one for now. I'll wind it down after this one. I'm getting kind of tired anyway. Alright, cigarette and play. Just imagine someone coming up to you looking like that and just like, ha, I like to eat shit. I don't know how I'd react, honestly. Like, it's pretty,
ha, I like to eat shit.
She just rolls up her window like, not doing this. Can't tell if they don't know what to think or if they're just like laughing their ass off and like, I can't believe that just happened. Like, I wish I would have been videotaping. Like, this guy and Jack Vale are right up there with some of those pranks or whatever.
Hi, is there any way I can just get you to shit on a bun for me and throw some ketchup on it?
Wait, you said what?
Any way you can just shit on a bun for me and throw some ketchup on it?
I remember the other one, it was about friends. Hang on, just like, watch that one and then we'll call it a stream, I think. It's just friend. Well, now I can't remember. There was one about being my friend. But I can't remember what the title of the video was. We'll just go with the good old phone losers. Oh, the pizza pranks are pretty funny. We'll go with this one. And then we'll probably call it a stream. Think I'm about ready to hit the hay here in a minute anyway. It's about 2:30.
Hello?
In the morning.
Hello?
Oh, hey, Kristen.
Who is this?
This is Steve Dave from the Domino's.
Domino?
Yeah, Domino's Pizza. Listen, ma'am, you need to stop ordering pizzas for your neighbors. We know it's you.
We know it's you.
You need to cut it out.
I'm not ordering no pizza.
Oh, yes, you are. You know exactly what you're doing. You need to cut that out. You need to...
give her the number because I have never ordered my neighbor a pizza.
You need to grow up, ma'am. You know, this stuff
no,
you're doing.
No, you need to call the police and file a report because I'm telling you, I have never ordered my neighbor a pizza.
Why did you get all defensive then? Because we know you've been doing this for years. You've been doing this for years.
Come here. Talk to my husband about this.
No, I don't want to. You need to.
We know you've been ordering these pizzas for years to your neighbors. You better just fucking own up to it.
Ordering my neighbors a pizza.
No, we're not.
Oh yeah, that's what you would say if you were doing it. I know your tricks.
No,
your lies.
Here's something to call your police number. 7-1 and give them my number. I have never ordered a pizza for a neighbor of mine.
Why
do
you
even have a neighbor?
Why do you know the police's number? You sound very dramatic.
Because I live in right on 25 Mile Road. I have never ordered a pizza.
We know where you
live.
You're always sending pizzas to your various neighbors, and they all
to your various neighbors
suspect
no,
you.
I'm not.
And we have,
I don't even know my neighbors.
Man, we have caller ID.
What are you trying to say, dude? What are you saying? We ordered a pizza?
And you know what, sir? That wife of yours, she was answering the phone with silly voices and being all weird at me.
Look at
so it's obvious she likes to play on the phone.
No, we don't order no pizza.
You need to tell that wife of yours to stop playing games.
What games?
Oh, her little pizza ordering games, just so she can stand at the window
no
and
pizza out of here,
watch the. No, she keeps ordering pizzas, fake pizza orders for all the neighbors.
No, she's not.
Oh yes,
she's not.
Not.
Maybe something's got out of her identity or something. But she didn't order pizza.
Sir, we have caller ID.
So, I don't know what to tell you, bro.
You tell her to shut up. Just tell her to shut up.
Go fuck yourself, asshole. Bye.
And, just a quick plug. If you have never been to fossphones.com before, one of the cool things we do is this. You can check out fossphones.com on the Gemini site. If you have a Gemini browser, check out Amphora on Linux distros, and I don't know what there is on Windows or Mac, but there's Gemini instances on just about every operating system. I've got one on Android, and there's plenty on Linux, and if you're interested in Linux phones, you can check that out. And that will just about do it for this stream. Thank you for joining us. We will see you guys either tomorrow or maybe Sunday. And you guys have a good rest of your weekend. Thanks for popping in.